There is no better way to truly experience a city other than to eat your way through it.
This is mouth art. Hang this taste in the Louvre, baby.
And I'm not just talking three square meals. I'm going to try every possible food moment. I'm talking breakfast, second breakfast, 11sies, lunch.
Oh, yeah.
3 o'clock sugar rush, dinner, happy hour.
Everything in here feels like a torture device.
Late night.
I'm thrilled about the idea of eating gator tail, which is a very underrated protein.
And then, of course, my favorite, brunch.
Are you going to grill chicken when this is out there?
My name is Mike Albanese, and while most people eat to live, I live to eat. Some people have their favorite type of food they want to try, but I want to try every type of food with every snack in between. This is one of everything.
Come on, what's going on, man?
A little about me. I'm a performer by trade, and when I'm not on stage, no matter what city I'm in, you can find me on some kind of food adventure.
You can see the gravy still glistening off of that. That's a good gravy.
And when I'm eating one meal, I'm already usually planning my next.
So the cornbread has a side of cornbread?
So this show is my actual life. I need to eat one of everything.
That's probably too much dip for one chip or for a lesser man.
And that got me thinking, why can't I watch a food show in the same way that I like to explore a city? I want to find every bite each city has to offer, but I also want to learn a little bit about each dish.
I can taste the cheddar and the crispy french fries, but the pickle mustard exploded in my mouth.
So come with me as I eat from the moment I wake up to the minute I crawl back into bed, leftovers in tow.
Yeah.
Each dish being its own adventure in my deeply rooted desire to eat what this show is all about. One of everything. Hidden just off a busy interstate in what looks like someone's grandmother's house is an Atlanta landmark, at least in my mind. Homegrown. From the moment you walk in the door to the self-serve coffee.
They have coffee set up for you because it's normally a big line. And they also have a little shop in the back, so I'm going to go hang around while we wait for our table.
To the xylophone music that serenades you as you eat. Homegrown has the exact breakfast vibe I live for.
I can't wait for breakfast. This place is one of the best places to start any day. It's called Homegrown, and I've never felt like there's anything other than my home. Although I can't cook sausage gravy like these guys can. They do every type of staple southern breakfast plus twists. They've got pimento cheese and fried green tomato sandwiches. They have slaw dogs, shrimp po' boys. I mean, this place is great. They're comfy chicken biscuit. They have a counter on the wall of how many people have ordered this over time. It's a giant, homemade, fluffy biscuit. I think they call it comfy because it's like a pillow. It's like two pillows with southern fried chicken topped with sausage gravy. And it is served with a side of a slice of orange because, you know, you want to be healthy. And they make a thing called the best French toast sandwich. Bacon, egg, spinach, tomato. I think that's going to be the move. That's what I'm going to get. Yes. Oh, wow. This is a classic French toast. This almost looks too good to eat. Like, this is the catalog photo of best French toast sandwich. The cheese grits looks like a solid brick of butter. And I'm definitely taking this whole egg setup and I'm putting it in the sandwich because I want it to just drip down over the rest of it. I'm gonna try to cut it. I think I gotta start in the middle because it's very thick. This is a huge sandwich. I'm not wasting that. Let me open this up so you can see. Oh. The yolk broke, but I couldn't be happier about it. I think it's actually better than doing it with my mouth, so that way it doesn't explode all over my face. I'm gonna take my grits, and I'm gonna put them underneath me, because I want it to be like a bib, like a little grit bib, to catch everything. And then I have this really incredible bowl of just everything in this restaurant in one bowl of grits. I'm gonna take my syrup. Oh! I'm nervous and excited at the same time. Here we go. This is mouth art. Hang this taste in the Louvre, baby, because this is something else. The saltiness of the bacon, the heavy sweet syrup, and that just creamy egg. I think this should come with like a bed that I could take a nap in immediately after, because this is gonna put me to bed. Oh. So now I've got this already amazing cheese grit bowl, but now it's got little bacon flecks, egg, syrup, and now it's gonna have my face. Yeah. Wow. The best way I could describe that is by having another bite. I think they should actually put this on the menu and name it after me and call it Mike's One of Everything, because it's got a little bit of everything from what I just ate, and now it's just this silly dish of grits. Old silly grits. I need to talk to a manager. So I just finished dinner. I'm pretty full at the moment, and I want to get a cocktail. There is a place in Atlanta. This looks just like a phone booth, but behind this booth, there's actually a bar. And the only way in is if you know the secret number. It's very top secret. I can't even show you. That's how secret this is. I feel like Superman, or like Clark, whichever one's first.
Oh,
I made it. I made it. That's rad, man.
I know, right?
That's so cool.
I can't believe someone gave you the number. So welcome to the Red Phone Booth.
This is amazing.
Classic 1920 speakeasy.
Yeah.
Extensive bourbon, whiskey, scotch, and Japanese whiskey selection. Squeeze all of our juices fresh, cranberry, lemon, lime.
Yeah.
And therefore, we're going to specialize in classic cocktails. Boulevardiers, old fashions, Sazeracs, you name it.
You're making me thirsty and hungry.
Hey, Bob, show them what you got back there. Double reverse osmosis, the clearest, cleanest ice. So when you're drinking your $200 scotch, $200 whiskey, you've got nothing but that beautiful whiskey or scotch coming through.
I feel like you make him do that all the time. It's like a workout for him.
We probably go through about 1,200 pounds a week.
Wow. That's a lot of cocktails.
It is a lot of cocktails. It's a lot of fun. Now I want to see you make our number one selling cocktail, the smoked old fashioned.
I think I got this. I'm just going to watch him do it more than anything.
We need a cherry.
Cherry. Okay. What do I do with this?
A cherry.
An actual cherry. I'm already screwing up.
You're good.
So that's the Luxardo. That's the maraschino from Italy.
Oh, these are like $50 for a can, right? Like they come.
No, actually more than that.
This is the zest of an orange, zest of a lemon.
Lump of sugar. A couple of dashes of bitters.
Bitters. Couple dashes. Is that too much? Too little?
Come on.
Hey, we're partying.
All right, muddle it up nice.
Muddle it up. Everything in here feels like a torture device.
Good, you're awesome.
We're muddled. All right.
Now let's smoke it up.
Oh, I forgot about the smoke part. Oh, you're like legitimately smoking this. I thought it was like a smoke flavor. All right.
Am I holding this? Going. Don't be scared. Let's get some
okay,
fire on
here.
Here
we go. Here we go.
Maybe a little bit of mesquite in there. All right, that's enough.
You got it?
Everyone has a little glass.
Here we go. Yahtzee. Yep. I feel like I'm looking at one of Saturn's moons. That's cool, man.
Crank the shredder.
I'm scared I'm going to hurt somebody.
There you go.
Woo-hoo.
There you go. Woo!
Oh, now this is where the real work comes in. All right. So we're custom making our own ball of ice.
This is hot, don't be scared. Just grab it on top and set it down on top of that.
This is copper, right? This is made of copper, so it conducts heat. Oh, you weren't kidding about that being hot. That's the big reveal. What? I never thought I could be a fan of ice.
So, a huge sphere of ice. It's going to have the largest volume with the least amount of surface area.
Yeah.
So it's not going to dilute your cocktail. And of course, you know our friend Bob Rudy here. He's got a signature.
This is next level ice. He is blowtorching what looks like a little signature martini, and he's going to brand the ice. What? That is cool, man.
And then finish it with just a little bit more bitters. And that is our smoked old fashioned.
All right, smoked old fashioned. Here we go. It's immediately hit with that smoke because I breathed it in with your nose, so it's like I feel like I'm at a campfire. By far one of the best drinks I've ever had. Bob, thank you so much. That was the coolest.
For me, the only way to cap off a night like this is some late night eats. And yeah, I could find some street meat or hit a taco stand, but when I'm in Atlanta, I go back to my roots. Pizza, baby. The Red Door lies just below one of the city's best and most authentic pizzerias, Pizza Amalfi. The food here tastes like you're in the shadow of Mount Vesuvius. With Napoli-trained pizzaiolas, there's simple, handmade ingredients and custom wood-fired ovens that were shipped directly from Naples, Italy, help create a truly one-of-a-kind flavor experience. And while I love to make pizza, and it is truly one of my passions, I much prefer eating it.